How do you connect people emotionally to a place and to their fellow community member? With the New Horizons Initiative, it's looking at how do we invest strategically in downtown adjacent neighborhoods through utilization of public spaces.
The objective of the initiative is to begin to infuse arts and culture into our community in a vast way.
I've kind of always thought that art led the way in community development. I always saw that connection.
We involve as many people in the vicinity of the public art as possible. And I find that collaboration in that way makes a tremendous change.
We see what it does for the people that do it. To us, that's the most important thing.
I think it shows the people who live there that people actually care about where they live, what they do, how they interact with things.
People take ownership, they take pride in it, they see a legacy there for themselves.
We love what it does because we know that it improves neighborhoods.
Most of the public art that we're seeing in Erie's visual landscape really relates to our population and our history.
I was born and raised around the Little Italy neighborhood. And the revitalization that is happening there through the Sisters of St. Joseph's has brought vibrancy to that community.
Sisters, for the past few years, have typically focused mostly on mural work and decorating the sides of buildings, which I think is a good first step. I think creating more a sense of place and physical objects for people to interact with can really push that a lot farther.
To ride over 18th Street and see the flags that replicate the childhood that I had in that community, it's beautiful.
Building owners, neighborhoods, when they find out that there's a mural coming to their neighborhood, the neighborhood is usually cleaned up.
Our most recent installation that's on 9th and State kind of led to that property owner creating a pocket park in that little area that was always kind of an eyesore.
Currently I'm fabricating a archway for their new Three Sisters Park. It was an overgrown double lot that kids would go in and play in, but started to get a little dangerous, so they purchased the park and have been renovating it. I think there's a lot of potential around here, a lot of small businesses starting to open up.
9 times out of 10, most people are trying to figure out how to get out of survivor mode. These art projects, the infusion of culture into these communities, will help them along their way.
Because we have so many different cultures represented in Erie, we need to make sure that all of those cultures see themselves represented in our visual landscape and our offerings as a community.
People can realize the commonality. This is a world that we all live, we all share.
I think a lot of people feel forgotten, left behind at this point. If someone, an artist or a group, can give something back, I think that helps.
I think public art helps them say, I have a voice and I do have a story. The community does want to hear that story.
Public art is free and it's accessible in the public realm. Every single person that calls Erie home is deserving of Erie living up to its potential.